This is Kumiko, and a single panel can cost anywhere from $2,700 to over $7,000, making this art style only accessible to the wealthy and high-end businesses. Until now. Want a backdrop for your office, art for your house, a trellis for your plants, or a background for your shelves? This video will show you the three steps to make your own Kumiko style panel, plus a fourth to bring your panels to the next level. And first we have to plan. We have an empty space above the dining table, so a slim but tall panel would fit perfectly. About 4 by 2.5 feet would be good. Once you have the rough dimensions, head over to my Maker World page, open the project, and customize the frame. In the customizer, you can input your dimensions to generate a reference panel. When used in conjunction with the corresponding print profile, you can organize which components are needed and how many to print. Want to skip steps 1 and 2 and start printing now? Subscribe to my Patreon to get access to the print profiles for all the projects along with the source code. Once all the components are organized, we can start printing. For this project, Bamboo Lab kindly sent me their new H2S 3D printer that came out, and it's been a huge help. I had to print over 2,000 components for this video, and thanks to the H2S having a huge print area, I could fit so many more components on one plate, which helps speed things up. The larger print bed also lets you print larger components like this 6x6 subpanel, which would have taken 3 separate prints to create on my P1P. What I'm really excited about is the laser attachment, which opens up so many opportunities to incorporate new materials into my projects which I couldn't do in the past. By the end of the video, you'll see how I use the laser to push the boundaries of what's possible with these panels and bring function to something otherwise only decorative. If you want more information on the printer, I have an affiliate link in the description below. For now, while the frame components print, we can head over to Kumiko Designer and begin designing our panels. Please consider donating to the creator if you use their tool. I really couldn't make this project without it. On the website, there's a huge number of patterns to choose from when designing your panel. You can adjust the colors, and once your design's complete, you can download a PDF to get the number of inserts needed for the design. With these numbers, you can head over to my insert generator and organize all the patterns needed for your panel. Optionally, if you have access to the files in Patreon, you could download the SVG and with a few steps, generate all the inserts in just a few minutes. For the dining table, I came up with 3 separate designs that you could choose from. I used 6 different colors in this project, but you could reduce or change the number of colors as needed. Once all the components are done printing, we can move on to the most satisfying step, assembly. The most important component in the frame is the subpanel. They interlock horizontally with dovetails and are joined together vertically using inner border components. I recommend placing super glue between rows to strengthen the frame overall. We can then place the border components and tie together the frame by adding the seam covers. Finally, we could start finishing the panel by placing the background pieces and adding the inserts. While I place the inserts, I wanted to take a moment to shout out some woodworkers that produce real Kumiko art. So if you want the real thing, make sure to check out their work. Pavel Dibrov, David Gutnick, and Martange Willems are all great woodworkers that make beautiful Kumiko pieces. Additionally, although he doesn't make Kumiko anymore, Desmond King's book series on Kumiko is a great resource if you want to try your hand at making your own. Links in the description. We could flip over the panel and begin getting it ready to be displayed. On the back side of the panel is where we'll attach the background border pieces. This is where we'll hang the frame from and is also where you can optionally add an LED strip to backlight the panel. This is the first time I incorporated LED strips into my work and I really like how it came out in the end. Using a template, we can mark and drill locations for the hanger, add anchors, and screw the wall hanger in place. I've been using these hangers for months and haven't had any issues, but they are a bit flimsy, so if you're worried they can't support the weight of your panel, you can make the hangers out of metal with the help of this video's sponsor, PCBWay. I sent the hanger files to be printed out of aluminum, and when they came back, I was really happy with how they came out. The surface finish was great, thin sections printed perfectly, and I didn't have to make any modifications to get the components to fit with my frame. I also made some stainless steel coasters, and I was surprised by how well all the sharp corners and thin sections came out. Not only can you print in metal, but PCBWay offers a huge variety of materials you can choose from, and provide many other services like CNCing and PCB manufacturing, among others. Check them out at pcbweight.com. After setting the frame in place and stepping back to look at what I made, there was just something missing. I had to go beyond. Sometimes to find inspiration, you need to take a break. So I went to Toronto, not for the busyness of the downtown core, but to take in the nature at the Toronto Botanical Garden. The buzzing cicadas, the winding paths, the beautiful plants. I found myself captured by the beauty in every plant, every flower. And that's when I realized what I wanted to do. I headed home and began working on the finishing touches. I wanted to add function to something otherwise purely decorative. So using the laser, I created plywood coasters of the flowers and plants I found throughout the gardens. I added a cork base so the coaster rests gently on the table when in use, and added a magnet so it could attach to the panel and is easily accessible. I also added test tube holders which let me incorporate flowers directly into the piece. So instead of leaving a bouquet of flowers in a vase, why not try displaying them in a more integrated and intentional way? Thank you so much for watching. Like the video and make sure to subscribe so you're notified about my next project.